Hello everyone, Donas here with ActionVFX. In this tutorial, I'm going to introduce you to the new UnrealReader Node from Nuke version 13.1. This node allowed us to bridge Unreal Engine with NukeX. I will demonstrate some of the features of this node and how to use it for compositing. So, without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so the UnrealReader Node basically allows you to read a 3D scene that you have made in Unreal Engine directly in Nuke. To allow your Unreal Engine to communicate with the UnrealReader node in Nuke, you must first download the Nuke server plugin on the description below, and then copy the Foundry folder that you have downloaded to the Unreal plugin directory. Okay, once you have done that, let's go to Unreal Engine. This is the 3D scene level that I want to read in Nuke. This is a Western Desert Town environment made by KK Design that I have purchased from the Unreal Marketplace. You can also purchase this environment in the description below. So what I want to do is to composite some fire and smoke using ActionVFX elements in this terrace here. And I want to do the compositing in Nuke. And here you can see I have already added some lights on the terrace to get some of that light interaction from the fire that I will add. So now we want to turn on the Nuke server plugin. So let's go to Edit, Plugin, and then click on Foundry, and then enable our Nuke server. Then, on your first time enabling this, it will ask you to restart. So you click Restart. I'm not being asked to restart here because I already have the plugin turned on from before. And then after you restart, you want to go to Window and click Nuke Server, and you will have this Nuke Server tab window. So now we can start connecting our scene level here to Nuke. First, what you want to make sure is to have a camera in your scene. So here I already have a camera. And then you want to create a level sequence, which what I already have here, and add the camera to that sequence. That way the reader node in Nuke would automatically attach itself to the camera. Of course, you can play around with the camera, maybe add a little bit of animation like I have here. Now, let's go to the Nuke server tab and click Start Server. Great, now let Unreal Engine run in the background and open Nuke. Now in Nuke, let's bring our UnrealReader node. And there we go. You will have your Unreal scene here directly being read in Nuke. So here on this side, we have the host and the port number matching to what we had earlier in Unreal Engine. And then here we have the fetch latest button, which is basically just a refresh button. So you can just go to Unreal right now, make some changes to the scene. And if it isn't already updated in Nuke, you can just refresh it with the fetch latest button. And here we have the map and the sequence that we are currently opening. And of course here you can change your map or your sequence if you like. And then here of course we have our frame range of the read node. And then here we have the render mode, which is full image or stencil. Full image is basically just the full render that we have here. Whereas stencil will open this tab that allows you to select and isolate individual object in the scene. So you can use this to isolate objects, or you can use the Cryptomatte on the render pass later. So next we have the render pass tab. So Unreal does not just bring the final beauty image render of the scene, but also the render passes that comes along with it. And the best part is we have the explanation of what each of these passes does. So you can then select which passes you want to bring out that you may need for your composition. And to do that, you want to select the pass and click the update channel list. And then we have advanced tab, which handles the anti-aliasing and other technical and more advanced settings. And then we have camera. This is the camera that we had earlier in Unreal Engine. You can click create camera here, and you will have the camera imported directly from Unreal Engine, complete with the animation. So this will be super helpful for compositing. You can choose whether to link the camera or not to the node. Linking it live means that you can go back to Unreal and make some changes to the camera, and the change will be updated to the camera in Nuke. And then another really cool feature of this node is you can create a camera here in Nuke and connect it into the node, and now the Nuke camera is being used by Unreal. And then next to the camera tab, we have the right tab. So if you are happy with what you have, you can just render out this Unreal Reader node as multipass EXR sequence. And then we have variables where you can play around the console commands in Unreal Engine right here in Nuke. And that's it. So now I'm going to do a simple compositing of this fire from ActionVFX Ground Fire Volume 2 collection on this building's terrace. I'm not going to go into detail about the actual file comping. I'm just going to show you how to use the informations that are provided by this node to help you composite elements to the scene. So first, we're going to get the camera, of course. I don't want to link it because I don't have plans to change the camera. And then let's go to the passes. We have this beauty passes that we can get, like this ambient occlusions, base color, lighting, etc. So you can select them if you want to make changes to the look of the beauty render. But for me, I like with the render as it is, so I'm not going to use any of it. But what I want is render passes that pertains to the physical placements of the scene, so I can use them to correctly place my elements. So let's start from the bottom. I want to add the world position pass, which, as it says, this will give me a full coordinate of every pixels in the scene. And then let's get our normal pass. Normal pass is similar to position pass, except instead of mapping the exact location of the pixels, it is more like the direction and orientations of the pixels in the scene. And then depth, and then I want to add Cryptomatte so I can select individual object of the scenes to cut up. And okay, now let's update the channel. And here we can see that we have our channels updated. Now we can directly work with this node if you like, or if you're already content with how your scene look, we can just render this out like I mentioned before, which is what I will do. So let's go to right and select the destination and render it out. Okay, so this is the rendered sequence of my Unreal Engine scene. Next to it is the Unreal Reader node. Again, you can work directly with the node. Basically, it's up to your preference. And here we can see that we have rendered out the render passes that we selected earlier. Now, I want to composite the fire into our shot. Now, since our shot here is moving, that means we need the camera or tracking data of the shot, which we already have in the form of our camera node here. So I'm going to get card 3D node and input our fire there. So this node is great for this instance because I can just position the card in 3D space and it would automatically output as a 2D image. So here what we want is to position our fire card in 3D space on the terrace, but we don't know where the terrace is in 3D space. So let's figure it out using our position pass from our Unreal scene. So let's get shuffle and select the position pass and then get the position to point node. And then on the first input, we're going to add in our beauty image. And then on the next input, it says position. So let's add in our position pass. And if we view the node and look in 3D, we have this weird blob happening. So let's reduce the size of the points. And there you go. We have projected our image in 3D based on the actual position of this building in Unreal Engine. Look how it even matches with the camera. A good tip I have to really help you position your elements in 3D space is to make sure your scene in Unreal is happening close to the world's origin point or the 000 point. That way, when you generate the position points in Nuke, it will be projected in a reachable area instead of spawning in somewhere far away. But if you want to move your scene in Nuke, you can do that also. For example, this camera and points are in a great range, but I want to rotate it a bit so it's not skewed in the y-axis. So let's get axis node, connect it to the camera, and then let's get transform geo node and input it below the positions to point node, and then connect it to the axis. And then use the axis to move both the camera and the projected points to the position that I want. Now let's add the fire to the terrace. So let's first connect the card 3D to the camera. And then let's put our fire on the terrace. Okay, so this is what we have so far. Now, one thing you noticed on my script is the position pass is not connected to anything on the main node tree. That's because the position pass is only here as a reference for blocking my elements. So I'm not going to render it out. Now, we want the fire to be behind these pillars. So we need to cut those pillars out and use it as a mat. There are many ways to do that, of course, one of which is to use the Cryptomatte pass that we rendered out. Currently, if we see our Cryptomatte channel, it looks really weird. That's fine, because we need the Cryptomatte node to transcribe it. So let's now look at our Cryptomatte node here, and we can see that our scene is now color-coded based on the scene's object. And from here, we can pick the objects that we want to isolate, and if we check our alpha channel, here we see how the objects that we selected are now matted out in the scene. So you can use this to help mask out the objects in the scene. However, for this specific 3D scene that I have, The pillars and the floor and the ceilings are actually merged as one object. That is how it is in the 3D world, so that's how Cryptomatte interpret it. So I could not use this Cryptomatte because I need to isolate just the pillars without the floorboard and the ceiling to obscure our fire. Thankfully, we have other passes with us, such as the depth and the normal pass. I'm sure there are ways to isolate the pillars, maybe using a position pass, but for this tutorial, I'm just going to show you one way to do it, using the depth and the normal. So to isolate the pillars, including the signs up there, let's get the shovel and get the depth map. And since the depth map are channeled on the red color, let's funnel that into our alpha. So now we're going to play in the alpha channel. So let's get some grade and change the grade channel to alpha. And let's create a contrast on the black and white point. Now, this is good, but the depth still includes the floor. So let's get rid of the floor. Thankfully, we have a normal pass. So normal pass, as I mentioned, is to show the orientation of object in 3D space. So the floor is now green because the floor is facing towards the Y axis. So let's select that green color. So I'm gonna funnel the green to the alpha, and then let's look at the alpha channel here. And then we want to invert it. So now the alpha is inverted, and then get a grade and then pull out the contrast like before until we have just the floor, and then add clamp to keep the values between 0 and 1. And then let's add in some roto to clean up the alpha a little bit. So now this is what we have. Now let's mask out our depth pass earlier with this. And there we go. We have successfully isolated the pillars. Now we are going to use this to stencil out the fire. And there we go. The workflow of using the Unreal Reader node to composite Unreal Engine scene in Nuke. Of course, in my final shot, I added some glow to the fire and also composited other ActionVFX elements like smoke and embers. This Unreal Reader node is a great addition to Nuke and extremely useful, especially for Unreal users and compositors. You can check out the Foundry's website for more information about this node and other new features on Nuke 13.1. And also, if you want to do some compositing using this new node, you probably want to have a high quality VFX assets, which you can get at actionvfx.com. At ActionVFX, we provide high quality VFX assets for your VFX needs. We have fire, explosions, energy, and many, many others. You can also sign up for our ActionVFX subscription starting at the low cost of $14.99 a month. This is the most affordable way to access our library, and you can cancel anytime, no contract. Thank you so much for watching. Let us know in the comment section below what kind of tutorials that you'd like to see next. And see you next time. Bye-bye.